this mall was built. 1998, man, things were rip-roaring cool back in the day. Dude, this place was epic. Let's go check it out. This camera stabilizer is a little off balance, but we'll deal with it. It smells like popcorn right when you come in because there's a movie theater upstairs. Cool thing about it is there's, you can see, like, this is very 90s, the wood tile floors. You see a lot of the stores that once were are no longer. Nothing here. We're gonna be seeing a lot of these type of stores that are just totally gated off. What's up, LimSG Easy? We are exploring the old mall and there's just nothing in here. There's vending machines where there once used to be a store, I believe. Yeah, and just emptiness, dude. It's pure emptiness. Shamla Tong, how are you doing? How are you doing, LimSG Easy? We're hanging out in Provo Town Center Mall, kind of showing you the vibes. So in there, it looks like they're busy right now, but that's a really cool store. Oh yeah, the Automotive Addiction Store. That's right. Am I allowed to film in here if I pay? Am I allowed to film in here if I pay?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome.
The only thing is you have to sand the tile.
No problem.
Okay, perfect.
Let me just pay.
We also have pay an my event dues. Tonight. That you
an event?
Yeah.
I have work tonight.
Okay.
Are there going to be a lot of famous car people here?
No. It's just, we just host car meets.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Like out in the parking lot? Like a bunch of people bring their cars?
Indoor and indoor.
Oh, so that's awesome.
The space on the back. Yeah.
How much is it?
$10.
Alrighty. You have change for $20?
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Of course.
How's the day been going?
It's been going pretty good. How about you?
Not too bad.
I mean, I'm surrounded by cars. Can't be too bad, right?
I know. So you're probably a car person then, right?
Of course. Did you want a seat?
No, I'm good. Thank you so much.
I love cars.
That's the way to do it.
What kind of cars do you like?
I like retro cars.
Okay.
I love the old ones, but I also love anything that goes fast and is low to the ground. So pretty much all of them.
Okay.
But I would say if I had an endless bank account, I'd be a Ferrari guy.
Okay.
For sure. I'm just working on the bank account right now. Cool. Thanks so much. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
So this is actually a place they have here in the mall, or they have a bunch of retro cars. Cool cars, new cars, older cars. Got this racing Nismo 350Z. How's everybody doing today? We are out and about here at the Provo Town Center Mall, and this used to be a department store, and they turned it into a place where they have a bunch of very, very cool cars. I would love to drive one of these buddies. Oh yeah. A little bit newer one here. What do we have? This is a 2002 Ferrari 575. You just gotta love it, man. You just gotta love those vibes. What's up, Missy? How you doing? We're looking at some beautiful cars, and this is actually at the Provo Town Center Mall, believe it or not. This is where they got it now. Oh, man, dude, no way. Ferrari from the 60s. This reminds me of the one from Ferris Bueller. Remember when he's, like, kicking the front of it? It's like, boom. It's like, my dad won't be able to not see this. It's totally like the one. Totally like the one from Ferris Bueller. What's up, Sassy? How you doing? How's everyone? We're looking at some fancy cars here. An old Lincoln Continental. This thing is awesome. Ooh, gangsta white walls. TV antenna in the back. So we are accepting donations, just FYI. Look at me, I'm actually out streaming without my sunglasses on. How are you guys doing? It's good to see you. I am your host, Mr. D9, Danny Wilson, out here. Wow, look at that thing's sick. Old Honda. That thing is cool, very chrome. Chromadescent. That looks like an old gangster car, dude. Wow, that SS is dope. Does it have a rumble seat? Look at that engine, dude. Whew. Big cow. Holy cow. What's up, Willis? How you doing? Dude, this used to be what, like a JCPenney's or something? And now it's just got supercars in it, man. So we're showing you guys. Willis, it's freaking good to see you. Yeah, we're gonna go vibe out. So big part, I wanna let you guys know that the new schedule is 3 o'clock my time, 2 o'clock LA, 4 o'clock Austin, yeah, 5 o'clock New York, and then some other time over there in good old London town. But we're gonna start going to historic places. Maybe some golf stuff, some skate stuff, but we're gonna focus on, yeah, that was Sears, that's right. We're gonna focus on historic places in Utah, and then eventually when I start traveling, but I love the retro vibes, as you guys know. Look at this thing, wow. What is that, an old Mercury? So sick. So I appreciate you guys coming through. How's your weekend been going? No way, look at that Rolls Royce. Yeah. It's like when I drove an old retro Bentley on one of my streams. But yeah, we got the stabilizer back. Got my glasses on so I could look like a champion. I look like I could be in a Kevin Smith movie, dude. Noinch, noinch, noinch. Smoking fatty, smoking blunts. Who smokes the blunts? We smoke the blunts. $15, little man. Put that in my hand. This is sick. Holy cow. This is McLaren, dude. Woo. I'd have to work for like 10 lifetimes. Okay, Willis, you're gonna love this, dude. Shout out to Willis. I don't even care about the McLaren. This is what I gotta buy for Willis, dude. I gotta get rich on YouTube and then buy this for Willis. And then I'll stand on the side of the road going, Isn't that crazy, dude? And they put so much detail into it. They really did. Are you serious, Willis? No way. Is that for real? I mean, I believe it. They put a lot of attention to detail, though. Land speeder. Isn't that so cool? Like, it would actually look like it hovers because it's got, like, the little wheels under there, but they hit them so well. I mean, if I could make that thing street legal, bro, could you imagine? I get it Monday, Wednesday, Friday. You get it Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday. And then, you know, YouTube musician, professional gamer, amazing guys, gotta travel in style, dude. It reminds me of the episode of Seinfeld where they pretend to be that guy, but he ends up being like some awful dude and they steal his spot in the limo. That's what it reminds me of. We got some motorcycles here, dude. Some pretty cool motorcycles. Not a huge motorcycle guy myself, but I do appreciate them. I do appreciate them for sure. So we got all sorts of different rides here. I don't know what this thing is, but holy cow, it looks so 1999, 2001-esque. Yeah, it was from 99 to 2008. That's totally like, you'd be listening to, "Do you think you're better off alone?" Do, 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 do. That's what we'd be listening to. This old 80s vibes. This thing is sick. I just love how well restored it is. It's freaking awesome. over here. Looks like a Great Gatsby type of car. This is a 1929 Auburn Cabriolet. Only 150 of those were built. Holy cow. Holy crap, this thing is nice. It's historical preservation right there, man. This guy freaks me out every time I come here. Freaks me out. What do they got back there? I don't think I'm supposed to go back there. It's so intriguing. Isn't that scary? You got a little dirt bike over there. Bing. Bing, bing. This thing is tight. Looks like G-Eazy would drive this car. An old G-Eazy car. We've got another SS Camaro here. It's a Fast and Furious type car. This thing is cool. Supercharged V8, 810 horsepower, 5.0 liter Shelby GT 500. Wow. Imagine that, 810 horsepower. Phew, man. Holy crap. This guy right here is sick. This is an AMG SLS Mercedes-Benz. This car was AMG's first chance to build their own car from the ground up. It's got 805 horsepower. Holy crap, that is wild. Shelby. That's so sick. I think G-Eazy actually has a Shelby. It's funny we were talking about G-Eazy. And the classic Al Cowlings, dude. Look at this, it seriously looks exactly like the Al Cowlings car, man. It's like, you know who I am. Erwin Kramer's running away with Gunnison. Isn't that crazy? Hey, Patty Skywalker, you like Star Wars, right? We gotta show you something we got over here, bro. Check this out. We'll go back to the land speeder. But real quick, this 80s bike is dope. What's up, Panay? How are you doing? Got a little, isn't this Sasley's dream car, but pink? Isn't this the one that she loves? Little Lotus Exige. Oh no, this is a Lotus Elise. Okay, so Patty Skywalker, you're gonna love this one. Coming all the way back over here for you. But I know you like that Star Wars vibe. Here we are. A white Ford Bronco is the real 90s flashback, for real. There it is, Patty Skywalker, a little land speeder. What's up, Sean? How are you doing? It's good to see you. It's really good to see you. Appreciate you being here. So we're out here. What I'm gonna start doing on these live streams is I'm gonna have more of a rhyme and reason to them. I'm gonna have sometimes I'll just go out and take you guys on errands with me, but I'm trying more and more to, show you guys historic places, because we like retro stuff here on this channel, historic places around Utah. And then when I get traveling, historic places around the world. Now look at this little sucker right here. Isn't that cool? Isn't this one just neat? Now this is a Nash Metropolitan back in the 60s, 50 horsepower. I honestly would love that. Patty Skywalker, I gotta agree with you. No way, that is so cool, Sean. 1.5 liter inline four cylinder. It was originally $1,527. And it gets 41 miles to the gallon. I want one of those, to be honest, dude. How sick would that be? Check this out, dude. A backdraft Cobra. This thing has got 520 horsepower, 7 liter engine. Over 800 welds, and it's only 375 pounds. Originally made in South Africa. Oh, and it's a Roush, dude. That's what I'm talking about. This thing, kinda, to be honest, I'm not trying to be a hater, look kinda like a death trap, but it is sick. Oh, dude, it's got a little parachute back there. No, I don't think so. I thought I had one of those little parachutes for drag racing. I know, right, Missy Millie? Isn't that crazy? How you used to be able to buy a car for as much as it costs to rent an apartment. Sassily, did you see your dream car? Rainier, what's up? How's it going, man? We're touring the Provo Town Center Mall where this used to be a Sears and now it's a car museum. Nice, thanks for studying, bro. You gotta get yourself in the good zone. Yeah, so that's Sassily's car that she likes. She just wants it in pink. So let's show you the black Lancer right here. Yep, that's your dream car, Sassily. What's up? How's it going, Crisis? Let me give you a little info about this Lancer, completely blacked out. Now this Lancer looks like, I'm guessing, like a 2007 or something. Let me take a look here. No, I don't even see a plaque for it. So I can't give you guys the info that I wanted to. Right here, let's check this out. Got the Lamborghini Huracan, 631 horsepower V10. Can't really even see in to see the interior. It's too blacked out. '14, 600 horsepower, all-wheel drive. And this thing goes 0 to 60 in 2.6 seconds. Hello, Jesus loves you, how are you? Right, Rainier. So yeah, again, Sassily, you just gotta paint that pink and that's your dream car right there. Hello, Jesus loves you, how are you doing? Good to see you. We got this sucker right here, Missy Millie. This is her Audi Extreme. I'm just kidding, no, she drives an Audi, but it's not as black as this one is. This one's all murdered out, all blacked out. Black on black on black on black. And then we got the Ferraris again for anybody who came late. Oh yeah. Rainier, did you see over there, there was the same car that G-Eazy has, the GT Shelby. A little Ferrari, and this totally reminds me of the car from Ferris Bueller's Day Off. I'll go. He'll keep calling. I'll go. So yeah, this is pretty rad. This McLaren is sick. Holy cow! Could you imagine just hopping into that thing? It's like the closest you get to driving a go-kart on the road. Look how close you are to the floor. Wow. So awesome. Didn't they have that car in one of the Pierce Brosnan? One of the Pierce Brosnan 007s? No, it's just so cool. The backs of these cars are just so wide. So neat. So that's it. That's the car museum, and now let's go look at the rest of the mall. Let's take a look at the rest of the mall. Cool cars, though. Definitely some cool cars. Oh yeah, and the Corvette. Let's not forget the Corvette. I know some people love these things. Alrighty, I'm all done. Thank you so much. That's so hard to say. Oh, man. Probably between the McLaren and this guy right here.
They're just so pretty. Like,
I think it's like the closest you can get to driving a race car legally. Because it's like so low to the ground, and it's just the handling and everything on it. Mm-hmm. I mean, if I had the money, go get one.
Me too. But, I actually got to sit in a BAC mono the other day.
No way.
It was so cool. Oh my gosh. Because my dream job is to be a race car driver, and I guess it was.
Really? Like, have you thought about, like, are you going to start going to, like, the driving schools and stuff?
It's like $7,000, though. It's
save
so
up
expensive.
Your pennies. Just
I know.
Keep, if it's truly your dream, just make it happen.
I know. I am.
That'd be so
to.
Sick.
I know.
It's going at, so what, so F1 much. Racing?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
I think it'd be so cool.
That's like me in a different life, you know? Wow. That's wild.
I don't know. It's unique.
Yeah, do it. Because we got Miller Sports right up the street, you know? Well,
I know.
Not right up the street, but it's only like an hour drive, isn't it?
I like driving.
Yeah. Go up to Miller Sports and make your dream happen. Thanks again. I appreciate it.
Yeah, have a nice day.
See ya. So there was that. We got to do that. Yeah. Remember the old Provo Town Center? What's up, DJ Rudin? How you doing? It is good to see you. So we've actually got a place in here that is a retro shop. Let's see if they let us go in. I have a question.
Yeah.
Do you mind if I film for my YouTube channel in here?
Sure.
Okay, thanks, man. So yeah, this place is awesome. It's got so much retro stuff in it. Let's start off over here with the old, talking about the old cartridges. That one day, at one time, yeah, like look at those graphics, dude, just skiing. Squeeze box. Let's see if we can find, casino. Right, DJ Rudin? Let's see if we can find the Mike Tyson's punch out a little bit later. Oh, here we go. Straight up. We're jumping. Oh, wait, what? Look at these, dude. Yes, ColecoVision, dude. Yes, sir. Pant Devil, thanks, man. How are you doing? I hope everything's going well for you. Hope things are going great. Okay, now here we go, dude. Skate or die, dude. Yes. Gilligan's Island, dude. Dick Tracy. I loved playing this game back in the day, dude. Dick Tracy. So good. Magic Johnson, dude. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, dude, Smallville on VHS, that's awesome. Track and field, nice. They had that pad that you could step on. Hogan's Alley, dude, yeah. Yeah, there's my game right there, dude. Bandai Golf. That's actually pretty sick, dude. I might have to get that. See what other golf games they have. I'm a golf game enthusiast. Oh yeah, dude, the classic duel right there. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, totally. Shout out if you guys see some of your favorite games. Yeah, Simon's Quest, dude, Castlevania 2. Classics, dude. Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, dude, they've got... Oh, dude, Kid Icarus? No way. That game is rare. Millipede. Oh, dude, no way. This game was so fun. I love this game. So this is actually really cool. Remember when they used to have these in stores where you could sit down and actually play? And it's got the Halo right there. Combat Vault, it's so cool, dude. It's actually a Microsoft TV. This thing is super cool. So we come over here, which is awesome. And we got all the Star Trek VHS. Right there. What's up, Patch the Retro Gamer? You're gonna love this store. Patch, you're gonna love all the retro games that we got in here. We got an old Xbox stand-up display. Got a whole bunch of Nintendo games. Some N64. It's old school, dude. Exactly, Pant Devil. Remember like in Walmart's when they used to have those? But here is something that's sick, as we have laser discs, man. Who remembers these? Dude, the cable guy. Let's see if they have any new ones in here. Yeah, dude, Three Ninjas. Oh, this is a great movie. Apollo 13. Oh, yeah, dude, another Three Ninjas. Classic retro. So, yeah, they've got a whole bunch of laser discs here. Oh, man, no way. An old red box. Over here, it's just like a little retro corner. Oh, do you guys remember these? Like the things you would put your VHS tape in to rewind it? It's classic, dude. What is this thing? This little halo? Like, I don't even know. What's up, James420? How are you doing? We're exploring an old 1998 model. We found a retro store. Some old CRT TVs. It's good to see you guys. It's good to be here. Tons of old VHS tapes. Remember, every house had these, just the bookshelves for either DVDs or VHS tapes. Oh, no way. Willis, this is for you. John, by the way, remember that guy? Got a bunch of old. Oh, nice, dude, some Scooby-Doo stuff. So it's the Simpsons Clue. See you in a minute, James. Ah, one of my favorite movies. Willis, he was a very interesting guy, to say the least. Oh, what is that? PlayStation Underground? It's kind of sick. Got some old PS2 games. Oh, nice. Some old PS1 games. Let's see if there's any that I want for my collection. I don't think so. Oh man, look at that, dude. It's like an oil baron board game, dude. That's crazy. Got a big old Pikachu. Maybe I'll get that Pikachu for my room. Big old Pikachu. Oh, nice, dude. Got some old consoles, dude. Original Xbox. Some more retro tech over here. Well, that's kind of cool. Robin Williams. Some old laser discs players. VHS players. I'll go and look in their collectibles case. See what they have. WrestleMania, that's sick. Oh, the original. Did you know my brother showed me? He's the first person to show me the original Grand Theft Auto on his computer. That way they've got Game Boy printer paper over there. You guys had something a while back. It was like a, I think it was a Bagger Vance. It was like a preview VHS. Did you guys sell that? Okay, thanks. That was tight. Alrighty. Well, that's that. Let's go on to the next store. How's everybody doing today? Remember Taiwan On? That seems like a place that one of your friends would have worked, Willis. Yeah, a lot of these things are just closed up, man. It's boarded up. This is where they usually put the big old Christmas tree. Oh, Western wear, dude. Should we go in the Western wear shop? Oh, yeah. I want some of these boots, man. Look how sick these boots are. Oh, it smells so good in there. This mall's actually, they've actually filled it out a lot more than it used to be. Got myself some bling. Some bling, bling, bling. And there are two levels on this mall, so we're gonna have to go upstairs. Oh, the Duck Hunt Mario one? I'm not sure. I think it was like $6. Got a hot tub right here. It's a hot tub chilling. This used to be a Victoria's Secret. Now it's a Runa Arts. This used to be a Victoria's Secret, as you can see from the carpet. I'm trying to fix this. This thing is just out of whack. I'm trying to just shove it in there. Ugh. Alrighty. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff. It's just kind of... No, they got some like bigger stores like Aeropostale, however you say it. But they got some other place that are just kind of... Oh, the duck hunting gun, right? He said, I already got a hot tub, nice. Yeah, I can get it. I'll make sure to get it. You want me to just ship it to you so you have it? Oh, it looks like there's more cars over here. Looks like we got more cars. And there used to be, this is where the arcade was. No arcade anymore. I miss arcades. I think arcades should make a comeback. It's one place to go kick it. Yeah, now it's just nothing. Okay, when I end the stream, I'll go and get it for you. Now it's just like a convention center, believe it or not. Or like you can, an event center, you can rent it out. It's a lot better as an arcade in my opinion. Yeah, I think there's a little resurgence, especially like barcades. Yeah, Dillard's no more, dude. There's no more. No more Dillard's. We got no more Dillard's, that's for sure. I wonder what they'll put there. Kind of a cool idea, paying by the hour. Okay, let's go up the escalator. Sure, I will. Everything must go. But how do I get in? I can't even get in the store. Please use the exterior doors. Yeah, I don't care. Wait, maybe they're selling. Yeah, they're selling like the stuff that's in there. That'll do. That'll do for our. Because we're talking about how malls are becoming abandoned. Yeah, isn't the architecture kind of cool in this mall? Definitely think there's a cool vibe to it. Yeah, dude, I'll try to find some of those. Dude, Rainier, I got my chair actually from a garage sale for $4. I got my awesome 80s garage sale chair for $4. Yep, dude, they get old. And that thing's made me a lot more than $4. It's the comfiest chair I've ever had. So I can do this for about 20 more minutes and I got somewhere I gotta go. I know, right? It's old gumballs. Going to look through the abandoned Dillard's. What? Go to the second floor? I didn't know I'd have to be doing all this walking. Yep, Provo Town Center. Right next to the freeway. Right, ref journalism. Yeah, we're here at the old Provo Town Center. And you can see that malls are just dying, dude. But this one's, you know, they're figuring out uses for it. But yeah, see, I can't even go through this door. It says 70% off. Maybe I'll find something cool. They're just trying to liquidate, man. See if I can go up this little embankment here. I don't think I can. Made it up to Dillard's. Oh no, Rainier, I need to. I'll do that, man. I'll get a gas tank or a gas can and do it. Last time I'll be going in this Dillard's. Pretty much everyone. Yeah, look how retro this is, dude. Holy cow. What I'm looking for is like, oh man, these lines are ridiculous. It's how it is now, man. It's like an apocalypse. Dystopian future. I get those boots. Hey, thanks, man. Have a good one. It's just abandoned, dude. That's what we were looking for, was this look, man. Whoa.
You have skinny legs, so it looks a lot better
than that. That's what I was talking about. These are the kind of shots I was looking for. Whoa. Isn't that so cool, like the lights shooting up? It's just creepy looking. Yeah. It's just emptiness, dude. We're venturing into unknown territory. Creepy, man. I know, right here. Empty, man. Yeah, here's where all the furniture is. Just on all the furniture, and I need something for like. $10? Dude, are you serious? Are you kidding me? Just like 10 bucks, dude. No way. If people needed furniture, this is where to go, man. 10 bucks, man. It's 10 bucks for this stuff. It's just too big for what I need. That's crazy, though. It's $10 for these tables. It's wild. I wonder how much these chairs are. $5, dude, for a chair. That's so incredibly, so incredibly 90s, dude. It's the most uncomfortable chair in the world. It's crazy how cheap it is, man. $2 for that? It's insane. They just want to get rid of it, man. They don't want to move it. This one's the one that's amazing to me. $10 for this thing, dude. This would be so much brand new. Oh, no way. I wish I had a bunch of room. I could totally use this thing. $15? Dude, you could repaint that? Holy cow, that would cost like $600 at a place. It's crazy. I know, right? That's pretty insane. I wonder if they're gonna sell this thing. If that's like part of the, man, I want to go downstairs so bad. Look at it down there. That's the back rooms down there. Now that's the back rooms. It's wild. Crazy down there. Man, I don't want to. Plus, I got something I gotta do at 4:15.